room, everyone. I'm gonna see you all here. All right, everyone. 25 years in comedy, 7 continents, HBO, Comedy Central, and everything in between. It's all led to this night. Are y'all ready? Are you ready? Ready? All right. Make some noise, everyone, for Mr. Tom Rhodes.
Hello, everybody. All right. That's a crowd on fire. You can tell when it's gonna be magic. All right, Austin, Texas, hallelujah. Hot, sweet ass. I'm getting a little older, everybody. I'm trying to mature. I'm trying to stop smoking marijuana. I want to have a family one day. I want to have children, man. You can't be someone's father and be all smoked up on the weed all the time. Daddy, there's a ghost under my bed. Well, don't fucking bring him in here. Tomorrow is 4th of July, and I want to remind everyone, never go boating on the 4th of July. Because you could have an accident and have to shoot up a flare, and everybody would go, that sucked. What the fuck was that? Did you say that? A friend of mine wrote on his Facebook status update that he was feeling suicidal and thinking about jumping off of a bridge. So I poked him. All right, everybody's on Facebook, man. It's amazing. That's how they're gonna find out things about us, because of what we like. I'm afraid to like anything. I've gone through and unliked everything I liked, man. I like it. It's amazing how much time we spend with our faces and computer screens now. I think through evolution and thousands of years, we're gonna need our hunting skills less, and our ears are gonna get smaller, and our noses are gonna get smaller, and our eyes are gonna get really big, and we're gonna look like fucking alien people. Anybody who's ever seen an alien has described it the same way. They had a big head and big eyes and little ears, little nose. And I think that aliens are just us from the future come back to visit ourselves. I don't have a punchline for that. But I like it very much. I think that the BP oil spill was somehow orchestrated by the beef industry to kill all the seafood. I want those Chick-fil-A cows investigated. I feel bad for the city of New Orleans, man. I identify greatly with the city of New Orleans because I am also recovering from various disasters. But if you ever go to New Orleans, man, you want to visit the voodoo shops before you get drunk. You don't be in there fucking around with a chicken's foot, not know what his purpose is. Then you go home and your parents are midgets. That'd be kind of cool, actually. That'd be the only way I could love my mom and dad more, if I could pick them both up at the same time. Oh, Tommy's home. Don't you think that a PT Cruiser looks like a midget hearse? Every time I see a PT Cruiser, I think a midget has died. I better turn on my lights and follow him. Just so it looks like the little fella had one friend. Technology is incredible now. A friend of mine has a new iPhone. Have you seen these things? They're amazing. And my friend showed me on his iPhone, he's got pictures of his girlfriend. He's got close-ups of her cookie and pictures of her blowing him, and I'm like, wow, you can do so many things with those. I've got to get a girlfriend. Actually, I have a girlfriend, hooray. We're all happy and in love and shit. We're in the running through the park with balloons stage of the relationship. You know, new love is like a narcotic, man. You can't do normal things when you're all crazy in love with somebody, like play a board game. You ever try and play Scrabble with someone you're totally in love with? Baby, will this move interfere with anything you're thinking about? It's okay. 5 years later, it's get your shit off the board. That ain't a word. Thought you went to college. You're a moron. You really thought smoot was a fucking word? Did you really think smoot was a fucking word? My girlfriend is Hindu. She believes in hundreds of gods. Sex is very exciting. She could yell out anybody. Krishna, Ganesh, 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 Steve. I gotta find out who Steve is, man. I need to read their scriptures. There better be a Steve in that book, goddammit. I want to go to India one day. That's my dream trip. What a fascinating place India must be. People in India starving to death. Cows are walking around all over the place. There's a sandwich right in front of you. Don't pray to the sandwich. Get off your knees and get a fork and stick it in his ass. We're supposed to eat cows, right? They're slow, they're fat, and they're tasty. If they weren't supposed to eat cows, they would have evolved thumbs and invented weapons by now. There'd be cows in trenches with helmets on going, dak, 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 dak. Moo. I like eating cows. I like Texas. You guys eat cows. I mean, I like veal. God, that's indisputable how cruel veal is prepared. It's raised in a box, never sees sunlight. But there's something delicious in the cruelty of it. I had some veal a couple weeks ago. It was delicious. I mean, you could almost taste the lack of hope. Austin, Texas. God, I love this city, man. You guys are so fucking cute. God, there's so many elements of people here that make me laugh. The fucking loser at the convenience store who paying for a beer with fucking pennies, and he's got a scratch-off lottery ticket. He thinks it's Las Vegas at the 7-Eleven, and just adorable. Seeing unwashed losers spending their hard-earned pennies like that and hoping for a new day. Then you got all your conspiracy theory Austinites, man. I love that shit. God, you guys give the government too much credit, man. You know how many conversations with friends of mine in Austin that have started with, man, you ever look at the back of a dollar bill? There's a pyramid, man. And at the top of that pyramid is an eyeball, and that represents the Illuminati and the same six rich people who own everything that we're all corporate slaves to. Wow. And they would have gotten away with it. Had they not left that huge clue on the back of a dollar bill. Wow. This is like a bad Scooby-Doo episode. Those darn kids ruined everything. We could have ruled the world, but we weren't smart enough. I was in San Antonio last week before I came here, and I love San Antonio. I feel tall, skinny, and pale there. It's good for my ego when I go to San Antonio, man. I always think I need to lose some weight, then I go to San Antonio and go, I'm a sexy motherfucker. Woo! I'm Leonardo DiCaprio, bitch. Friend of mine in San Antonio took me to, restaurant, country club type thing, and he goes, the Kobe burger here is really good. I said, man, if I'm gonna eat a burger named after a professional athlete rapist, I would prefer the Ben Roethlisberger. Yeah, I'm a big fan of Texas. I really like San Antonio too, man. But I think the Alamo is a misrepresentation of reality. You go to the Alamo and there's all these statues, the white Texas dudes. They were the losers. Since when do losers get statues? The Alamo should always be remembered as Mexico's greatest victory when Santa Ana came here and kicked our ass. And in honor of that, we allow Mexican people the right to sell snow cones out in front of the place. Congratulations, I'll have a blueberry. I would like to commemorate your victory with a blue tongue all afternoon. I do love Mexican people. I love everything Mexican. That's why I love Texas so much. I don't understand the racism in this country against, well, fucking everybody, but it's so hardcore now against Mexican people. Like, they built a wall at the border between the United States and Mexico, man, and that just angers me. These are the people who gave us the margarita. Why would we separate ourselves from such magic people? I don't know if you read in the newspaper last year, but Mexico is considering legalizing all forms of drugs. If they do that, they have to build a wall to keep me out. Mexico, por favor, it's your amigo Tomas, please, Mexico. I can do yard work. I can clean. I'll stand in front of El Casa Depot all day. We need to annex Mexico, make it part of the United States, everybody. That's our destiny.
Yeah.
We need to annex Mexico, make it part of the United States, and we need to get rid of our flag and adopt Mexico's flag. It's got an eagle standing on a cactus, squeezing the shit out of a rattlesnake. Nobody would ever fuck with us if we carried that flag. Does anybody fuck with Mexico? No, and it's because of that flag. We need to annex Mexico, make it part of the United States, and we need to send the drug cartels from the north of Mexico to Iraq and Afghanistan and fucking turn them loose, baby. Yeah. And those Iraqis and Afghans would be left to wonder, who are those people with the Virgin Mary tattoos? They were the most ruthless people we had ever met in our lives. We should have looked at their flag and known not to fuck with them. I love everything Mexican, man. I love mariachi music. That shit's so sexy. And the dudes wear them pants with the sexy silver shit on the side. I don't know how girls can keep their pants on when that shit is playing, man. Fucking blah, 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 blah. I do not like Tejano. That's when they incorporate the accordion. I do not like the accordion. I find it one of the most annoying instruments ever. And this is a fact, and you can look it up. The accordion arrived in Mexico because of the Germans. A few hundred years ago, the Germans were in Mexico doing some German shit. And they left behind all of these accordions. And that's how the accordion was incorporated into the music I love, mariachi, and bastardized into what is known as Tejano. And I think that right after the Holocaust, that should always be remembered as the second worst thing that the Germans ever did to humanity. I like coming to Austin. This makes up for a lot of shitty gigs I've done. I was in Wichita, Kansas, however long ago you need for this joke to be relevant. And the club owner comes up to me after the show and he goes, hey, don't say fuck here. If Bill Cosby was here, he wouldn't say fuck. I said, if Bill Cosby was in Wichita, Kansas, making the money I'm making, he'd say fuck. I'll bet you a pudding pop. I was in Kansas, had all these tornadoes that just wiped out all of these mobile home villages. When are people gonna stop making mobile homes? I mean, the smartest pig lived in a brick house. So Some of my jokes are designed to make one person laugh at a time. Do not be alarmed. Your joke will be coming around shortly. I have individually wrapped one for each of you. I was in Wichita, Kansas, and they had no sense of humor at all at this comedy club. They had all these specialty drinks named after famous comedians, and I was sitting at the bar waiting to go on stage, and it was a new bartender, and he asked the waitress, he said, "Hey, what's a Jerry Lewis?" I said, "Oh, it's a Jack and Coke, but a retarded kid brings it out." I've tried victimless humor, people. It's just not funny. I said that to the bartender, and he goes, "Did you hear that? That's the sound of heaven's gates closing on ye." Wow. One retard joke, and I'm out of heaven. That's how fragile the whole program is. I think that hell was a concept created to get dumb people to act right. At least that's what I'm counting on. It's hot, baby. I'm from Florida. Florida and Texas have a lot in common. Florida and Texas in the summer gets in the 100s. Some people hate that it gets that hot. I always loved the 100s. Because my dad is the cheapest son of a bitch that ever lived. We had this 100 degree air conditioning rule in our house. We could not turn on the air conditioner unless it was 100 degrees or hotter. June and July always sucked to be teetering at 98, 99. Everyone in the family's lying on the carpet like they have Down syndrome.
Oh God, please let it be 100 today. Please let it be 100.
And then it would hit 100. Oh, cool air, woo! It's the first time my balls haven't stuck to my legs since the spring. What mobility! I can move freely now, my sack is clear. I was in London, England last year, and I did that joke. Just the worst thing you could ever imagine as a comedian, man. This woman comes up to me after the show, and she goes, "My son has Down syndrome, and some things should not be made fun of." I said, "Well, turn on your air conditioner." England's a funny place. It's funny, like, such a small island that England is, all the phenomenal music that has come out of there. One of my favorite bands of all time is Led Zeppelin. Yeah. But, you know, if you listen to those songs, man, you know, from one of the greatest rock and roll bands ever, man, they had a lot of trouble with the ladies, man. "I got a woman that won't be true. I got a woman stay drunk all the time." That might be a red flag, man. "The way you call me another guy's name when I try to make love to you." Maybe this ain't the girl for you, Bobby. It's funny, in all those songs, Led Zeppelin, Robert Plant always did all those moaning sexual frenzy noises. I mean, if that guy didn't have a band, he would have been fucking arrested. If it was just one guy in a park making all those noises by himself. Mommy, what's wrong with that man? Hurry along, children. I actually met Robert Plant one time. It's an incredible story, actually. I was driving from Los Angeles to Las Vegas, and I had like an old shitty car at the time, and it was hot, man. Like, hot enough to be dangerous, and my car broke down, and it overheated, and I'm on the side of the road, man, it's fucking hot, like dangerous desert hot where motherfuckers can die and shit. And just all this steam and shit, I got my hood up, and just steam is just fucking shooting out of my engine, and this limousine stopped. And Robert Plant from Led Zeppelin got out of the limousine and actually fucking helped me. He looked underneath my hood and he said, "You need coolant." I was in Alaska last summer, and there was a very interesting story on the news the week I was in Alaska. Four homeless people had been eaten and killed by bears. And that's what I like the most about Alaska, is if you're homeless, you're part of the food chain. Come on, Austin, wouldn't that be great? If once a year, bears came into the city and ate all the homeless people? We could teach them to lick the blood up off the sidewalk before they go back to the mountains. I didn't know what to expect in Alaska. I thought they might still pay with shit with beaver pelts or something. Thought I'd go into a store and I'd throw down my beaver pelt. They'd give me some squirrel hides back for my change. I'd be like, "Nah, put that in that styrofoam cup that says, need a squirrel hide, take a squirrel hide, got a squirrel hide, leave a squirrel hide." I ate Alaskan king crab every day that I was in Alaska. Alaskan king crab is my second favorite taste on the planet. Alaskan king crab dipped in hot melted butter. Versus flesh rose petals glistening with saliva. Why don't the Jelly Belly Jelly Bean people ever come out with either of those flavors? Blueberry, buttered popcorn. Mmm. Pussy. And the women in Alaska are wildebeests. I mean, cyclops bitches with humps. And the women in Alaska all wear sweatpants and free cigarette giveaway t-shirts. You go there and it's no mystery why they worship Sarah Palin. She's the most fuckable woman in the whole state. And in a way, it's a pity that John McCain did not become the president. Because Sarah Palin would have been the first vice president that I wanted to titty fuck since Al Gore. It's an inconvenient truth. I saw you sending a text there, man. Is everything cool? I don't mind. I'm the text-friendly comedian, baby. I'm just glad you text. Do you have any friends who don't text? I sent a buddy of mine a text. He didn't answer me back. Next time I saw him, I was like, "Man, I sent you a text." He was like, "I ain't into that." It ain't a sexual preference, motherfucker. It's a mode of communication. I know, I just ain't into that. All right, Mr. Butterchurn. You take your Sony Walkman back to the museum. And the rest of us in the new millennia will be communicating anywhere we can. So hold on loosely. And don't let go. One of the main reasons I love Austin, Texas, and I loved Austin, Texas before I ever even came here and learned anything about it. I'm from a little town outside of Orlando, Florida called Oviedo. And I lost my virginity with Marla Coleman from Austin, Texas. One of the happiest days of my life was when Marla Coleman moved from Austin, Texas to Oviedo, Florida, and I just fell instantly in love. And she had this deep, syrupy Texas accent. Oh, Tommy, you're so fun. And my dick would get so fucking hard, man. And she was my high school sweetheart. There was nothing cheap about this story, baby. I love this woman. And it was Florida, and we swam every day, and we'd kiss and swim and kiss. And to this day, the smell of chlorine on a woman drives me crazy. If I ever come out with my own cologne perfume, it would smell something between chlorine and Hawaiian tropic coconut. Because that's what Marla Coleman always smelled like, baby. And I lost my virginity with Marla, and I loved her, and it was pure, baby, and she was from Austin, Texas. It was over with Marla Coleman when she went to the 38 special concert with Kevin Yentz. And Kevin Yentz wasn't cool and artsy like me. He was some musclehead football dick jock fuck. And everybody in the school knew before I did, and I had to walk the halls in shame, baby. You remember how shit hurt you when you were 16? Oh my God, I could have fucking shot up that whole goddamn school. I mean, my fucking heart was broken. And for years, I could not hear a 38 special song without feeling that 16-year-old heartbreak twist in my chest. Thank God they only had two hits. So I just want to thank Marla Coleman for not going to see the Rolling Stones. Yay, let's have some more beer, huh? Sure. Cheers, friends, hooray. I love drinking. Drinking creates conversation, don't you think? You gotta call people the next day and apologize to them. I stopped drinking Jack Daniels. The last time I drank Jack Daniels, I broke my leg. I thought it had called me an asshole. I love wine. It's my secret ambition in life to be a wine reviewer. But I'm American. I have a very limited vocabulary. All my wine reviews would be like, that's some pimp-ass wine. Do I smell motherfucking apricot? So all my family are hardcore Republicans, and they hate Barack Obama. They hate the guy so much when they talk about him, spit comes out of their mouth, they get so upset. My family's upset that Obama won the Nobel Peace Prize. I think the man showed remarkable humility and constraint. His Nobel Peace Prize acceptance speech should have been, is that you kissing my black ass? It is you kissing my black ass. Obama's getting a lot of negative news media. I think America's afraid. We're afraid once we go black, we'll never go back. White people never say cool shit like that. You never hear, once you go white, you may also enjoy a Sprite. Oh, man, I gotta quit smoking cigarettes. I love it, though, man. I love cigarette smokers. I don't know any cigarette smokers who are prejudiced. Because all cigarette smokers know, we're all black on the inside. There's worse habits than smoking cigarettes. Country hillbilly fuckers do that tobacco shit in their lip. That's gold Copenhagen shit. And I don't know what sensation it gives them. I don't know if it helps them focus when they're strangling minorities. I've never done it, but I don't know if you saw on one of these news programs earlier this year, they had this guy did that tobacco shit in his lip and he got cancer and they had to remove his jaw. It was gruesome, man. The dude had no chin. His lips just went straight down to his chest. And he's on TV being interviewed going, I didn't expect that to happen. I'm looking at this guy and I'm thinking, how does this guy fold pillowcases?
It's so wrong.
So unless you want an unruly linen closet, stay away from that stuff. Last week, 2 weeks ago, before San Antonio, I was in Japan doing shows for our United States Marine Corps, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, it's a real honor to perform for the troops. And you know, a lot of these guys are right back from Iraq and Afghanistan and they need a chuckle, you know, but some of them Marine shows were tough, man. God, there were a couple nights where like somebody fucked my mom. Because that's where their level of humor was at. Hey, I fucked your mom! Thanks, hero. That's interesting. You fucked my mom. Wow. You may have noticed that I'm a little overweight. And that's because every time I fuck your mom, she gives me a cookie. And the Marines laughed and laughed. We gotta change our strategy in these wars, man. I mean, shit, this shit's just dragging on. I mean, I think we should mix it up, you know, one day bombs, another day confetti. One day bombs, another day rubber chickens. Oh shit, I hate rubber chicken day. It's like they're making fun of us or something. I remember years ago, I read a thing that said that the money that the United States spent on the Vietnam War, we could have built each Vietnamese family a $300,000 home. I don't know why we don't ever try that approach. Make them love us to death. We should build water slide parks all over the Middle East. How much happier would they be if they could go down refreshing water slides? Bully, bully, bully! See those dudes with the big long beards at the bottom of the slide? That's all fucked up. You thought a cute little joke about a Muslim guy in the Middle East wringing out the water in his beard from a water slide was fucked up, but a retarded kid bringing a Jack and Coke was no problem to you. You thought that it was the Muslim guy innocently wringing, a joke I could actually do on television. You thought that was the more fucked up. More fucked up than the guy with no chin doing his laundry. Okay, all right. Just checking your meter, baby. Just checking your meter. Just seeing where you're at, man. The world is full of fucked up things, young man. I have a certain love of, and it's another reason why I love coming to Texas, man, is I love barbecue pork, baby. Yeah. I love barbecue so much, I don't know why no one has ever come out with a barbecue sauce flavored lubricant. To the bone. But I had never eaten at this place here locally called Stubbs, and somebody told me that that was a really good place, and I went there the other day when I arrived into town. And I went into this barbecue place, Stubbs, and I walk in the door, and there's a dude in there eating, and he's got a tumor the size of a fist growing on the side of his head. It was all bumpy and gory and weird and shit. It was obviously something that somebody should have had looked at a lot sooner. But I saw this guy and I got happy, because I figured, you know what's some good barbecue if it brought this motherfucker out of the house? That dude don't go out on accident. Yeah, baby. What are you guys whispering about? What you gonna do later? Cool. Nothing like a facial deformity humor joke to make you think about what you're doing later. Oh, God. Guy had a tumor growing on the side of his head. What do you want to do later? I am obsessed with the World Cup, ladies and gentlemen. I'm gonna be sad when it's over. I'm gonna need a friend to stand outside my window and blow on a vuvuzela. Today was a really difficult day for me. I watched Argentina get crushed by Germany, man. Fuck you, punk! Did you forget about the Holocaust and the accordion so soon? No, it was a difficult game for me to watch because I'm actually half Argentinian. My mother is from Buenos Aires, Argentina, and that's where I get my tango sexy cool. And I've got cousins in Argentina, and I've been there like 3 times now, and I have a cousin in Argentina named Fernando, and he's the sexiest Argentinian guy you'd ever want to see in your life. Hey, Fernando, do you have any matches?
No, but isn't my body beautiful?
And I really learned a lot about myself in Argentina because I've always been moody, arrogant, and a little bitchy. Just turns out I'm Argentinian. I know it's kind of cheesy, but I like to call friends of mine handsome. How you doing, handsome? Who doesn't like to be called handsome? So before I went to Argentina, I learned, hola, guapo. My cousin Fernando said, Tom, in Argentina, when you call a man handsome, he thinks you are a faggot. There's such a macho culture, any sign of femininity, and you're a faggot. Which is really interesting, because all the men there greet with a little kiss on the cheek. Tom, in Argentina, you know not want to look like a faggot, but here's a little kiss for you. The very first time I ever went to Argentina, my cousin Fernando took me to a soccer match. My family's from Buenos Aires. Their team is River Plate. River Plate was playing Quilmes, which is 30 miles outside of Buenos Aires. And the home fans cannot sit with the visitor fans. They gotta enter separately in the stadium. We walk in the stadium, this fucking field is surrounded with walls of razor wire. Not barbed wire, razor wire, you touch it and your hand shred. Okay? So River Plate is beating the shit out of Quilmes 4-1, and the home team, hometown, is so angry at their own team, they set the stadium on fire. All of a sudden, on the other side of the stadium, there's a big fire. And then these crazy lunatics try and climb the razor wire, and like 5 or 6 of them, and then these riot police come out with helmets and shields and batons, and they start beating the fucking guys off the razor wire. And they canceled the match with 20 minutes left, And they kicked out the hometown fans first, and we all had to wait like an hour because they didn't want clashes in the streets. And so we're waiting there, and it's a school night, and these people got to work the next morning and get back to Buenos Aires, so they're getting restless, and they're banging on the doors, and the cops shot tear gas canisters over the wall into the crowd. And there was a frightening moment where, like, holy shit, this is where people get trampled to death. But they had dealt with tear gas before because they just picked up the canisters and threw them back over the wall. But it was one of the greatest nights of my life, man. I've been to 1,000 baseball games. Nobody ever set the stadium on fire. And I have seen some performances that had warranted it. I wish the United States was more into soccer, and we need to spend less money on our military, less money on our space program, and put all of our money into soccer. And all of us playing soccer 24 hours a day, we need to be kicking checkered balls into nets and teaching our children to do so. Because I have traveled the world, ladies and gentlemen, and the only way we are going to break the hearts of the rest of the world is by beating them at the only thing they truly love in life. And then we'll give them a bowl full of pussy-flavored jelly beans. Had to make it funny somehow. Aren't you Keith Stone? That was fucked up. Sorry. I like your hair, man. I had long hair once. Then I bought a calendar and realized it wasn't 1986 anymore. No, it's fucked up. Look at my bald spot, man. It's not a bald spot. That's an old breakdancing injury. All right. We got to wrap this up soon, I guess. I miss the Olympics. I miss the Olympics for this one move. Why are gymnasts the only ones allowed to do that pimp-ass move, man? We need to steal that shit, incorporate it into our everyday lives. Whatever your job is, when you finish a task, you should plant and nail it. If you're a mailman, you put the letter in the hole. Feels good, people. Well, go on then. I'm tired of your wavering loyalty. Boxing is one of my favorite sports, but I do not like UFC fighting. I find it very bloody and violent. And it's really homoerotic when the one man is on the ground and the other man is on his knees over him. I have my dick in your face and I'm punching you in the face. I have my dick in your face and I'm punching you in the face. Whenever I see that, I always think to myself, are these the deleted scenes from Shawshank Redemption? Welcome back, friends. I miss the Olympics. I miss the Olympics for this one move. Why are gymnasts the only ones allowed to do that pimp-ass move, man? We need to steal that shit and incorporate it into our everyday lives. Whatever your job is, when you finish the task, you should plant and nail it. If you're a mailman, you put the letter in the hole. Boxing is one of my favorite sports. But I do not like UFC fighting. I find it bloody and violent. It's really homoerotic when the one man is on the ground and the other man is on his knees over him. I have my dick in your face and I'm punching you in the face. I have my dick in your face and I'm punching you in the face. Whenever I see that, I always think to myself, are these the deleted scenes from Shawshank Redemption? Now, you didn't miss anything from your pee break. You are completely caught up from the pee break. You are welcome, my friend. Any questions about anything we've covered? The Netherlands. As a football team, or my personal experience with the Netherlands?
World Cup, man.
The World Cup, man, they look fucking hot. I couldn't believe they beat Brazil, for fuck's sake, man. Come on,
lost
shit.
Lost like 14 games.
Who did?
Netherlands haven't lost like 14 games.
They're on fire right now.
Yeah, they're gonna lose to Germany in the finals. Oh. And Argentina had to go home. It's bad.
Man, what the fuck do you know? I watch ESPN all day. I never seen it. We're gonna bring out some burnout stoner from Austin right now to get it. Lottery tickets sticking out of your pocket. You got your beer, you paid with a penny. It's gonna be the Netherlands and Germany in the final. And I feel that Germany's gonna beat them. No, I'm glad you're into soccer, man. It's great. And no, I'm pulling for the Netherlands myself, because my girlfriend is from Holland, and she's Indian, but she's from Holland. She is. And I lived in Amsterdam for 5 years, and God, I loved living in Holland, man. The women are beautiful in Holland. I'm serious. When I lived there, every once in a while, I would have to go to England just to rest my eyes. Talk show on Dutch television for 3 years, and then when that ended, the same network gave me a travel show. We'll come back to that. But it was great. I was like the David Letterman of Holland, and I got to interview all their Dutch celebrities, and there was a few Americans that were on, like Steve-O stapled his ball sack to his leg when he was promoting his film. And but my favorite thing about the show was every episode there would be a 5-minute film where I would experience something of Dutch culture. Like one episode, I got to spend a day with a Dutch farmer and I walked into an electric fence. The guy said, look out for the electric fence in Dutch, but I don't speak Dutch, so I went blah, 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 blah. And Dutch people think I'm fucking Charlie Chaplin because I will walk into an electric fence for some laughter. But there was another episode where I was given a tour of the red light district by a former prostitute who actually helps the prostitutes. She does a lot of benevolent social work, like helping them get their health services and pay their taxes and whatever. She's kind of a notorious famous woman in Holland. And she gave me this tour of the red light district, and she took me to a sex club. And I'd never been to a sex club before. And this dancer comes out, like they had people having sex on the stage, which was really disconcerting. Because like, you know, you think you hate your job. These fucking people were like so not into it, man. Like, it's the least erotic thing in the world. And then some dancer comes out and she's dressed like the Grim Reaper. Death. She had a sickle and everything. She put down a circular cloth on the stage and it had a devil pentagram star on it. The girl stripped naked, flipped upside down on the devil pentagram, took a candle, stuck it in the closest thing she had to a candle holder, lit the candle on fire, and then she did this breakdance thing where like her legs go all these different directions, and the fucking candle never moved, man. And the flame never went out, and I'm sorry, that is beyond my Christian sensibilities. I'm going back to that club one day. I'm gonna get a squirt gun full of holy water. I'm gonna jump out behind the seats and pop, pop! We're gonna get some Jesus into that girl, even if it's one drop at a time, in her satanic little butthole, okay? Little Jesus for you, pop, pop! I should have ended this show 10 minutes ago when it was all funny and strong. I do this in real life, people. I will stay at a party 10 minutes too long. Everybody be fucking loving me all night, and at the end of the night, I'll just turn into a dick, and I'll go, God damn it, I should have left. You gotta know when to leave the party, baby. I did a radio interview a few months ago and they introduced me as the bad boy of comedy. I never said I was the bad boy of anything. Nor do I want to be introduced as such. Only in comedy do you ever hear that. You never hear that in other professions. You never hear, he's the bad boy of gynecology. See the dude put on his gloves with the fingers cut off. That if you are ever attacked by a pit bull, that you should stick your finger in its asshole. My question is, what if that's the reason the dog is biting you in the first place? Way to go, tough guy.
Hey.
Yeah, you were all cool till you got to the door and couldn't fucking open it. You had to saunter down and then fucking you thought it was just a push thing, but no. It was a knob and you looked like a jackass. All right, let's wrap this up, huh? Aww. I really like Texas, and Austin is so unlike anywhere else in Texas, as you know. I was in Dallas, Texas last summer. Well, let me preface this story with, don't be a dick. That was Jesus' whole message. Don't be a dick. I was in Dallas, Texas last summer, and I'm driving around on a Saturday afternoon, and there was a protest in front of a Honda automobile dealership. 30 or 40 people marching angrily with placards and signs. And their signs said things like, gay is not okay, and the word of God condemns homosexual acts. It was a curious sight, and I stopped, and there was a guy, he looked like Moses, I figured he was in charge. I go, what's happening, man? And I swear to God, the guy goes, well, it seems some people who claim to be Christians have hired some homosexuals to sell Hondas. And the Lord don't want homosexuals selling Hondas. Does it say that in the Bible? I admit, I skipped around a lot. It could be in there. I thought the whole point of the book was love your neighbor. It doesn't say go to his work and fucking bother him. If those people truly would have been following the Bible, their signs would have said, my gay neighbor drives a Honda and I love him. My Peter-licking neighbor gets 44 miles to the gallon on the highway, and when he doesn't have a ball sack draped across his nose, is getting 33 in the city. Yeah. I'm from the state of Florida, and my favorite rapper is Flo Rida because he is from Florida. You know, when he came out, every rapper in Florida went, aw, damn. All I had to do was hit the space bar. It was right there the whole time. Yeah, I'm from Orlando, Florida. We have a SeaWorld. And there's also a SeaWorld in San Antonio. But the difference is the Shamu at the Orlando SeaWorld has killed 3 human beings. And they should have known that whale was trouble when they bought him, because he had 3 tattooed tears on his cheek. The first show tonight sucked a donkey dick. It was full of old, tired-ass white people who came over here after Esther's Follies, and these motherfuckers stared at me like I was a 3-headed goat or some shit. And you have just changed my night for me, lady. You changed my life for me. I'm like, wow, shit. I'm making somebody laugh hard, man. I just... Thank you for that. So it had been about 15 years since I had been to Disney World, and a few days after Christmas, I took my girlfriend and my mother to Disney World. And my favorite thing about Disney World is that the little kids wear the Mickey Mouse ears all day. And they actually sell those in adult sizes, and I thought, I want to be a little kid all day, man. So I got the Mickey Mouse ears, and my girlfriend got the Minnie Mouse ears, and we had a really nice day at Disney World. And then later in the afternoon, we're eating in one of these Disney restaurants, and my girlfriend had this misunderstanding with this Brazilian woman at the next table. They're sitting on like a bench, and you know the plastic trays at McDonald's you carry the food on? This Brazilian woman got pissed off about something. She slapped the trays, and they slammed her against my girlfriend's thigh. My girlfriend went, bitch, and the Brazilian woman jumped up, and then her muscular Brazilian husband jumped up, and that's animal instinct shit, man. You gotta protect your woman, so I fucking jumped up. And the Brazilian dude stepped in on me, and I can't believe this guy's ready to fight at the happiest place on earth. And I bowed up, and I'm ready to throw down, and I realize I got these dumbass Mickey Mouse ears on. Thank God Mickey and Goofy came running over, and they pulled us apart. Mickey was holding the Brazilian guy back, and Goofy was holding me back. I was like, fuck him, Mickey, he didn't buy the hat. He don't love you like I love you, Mickey. Goofy, get the fuck off me. Never liked your shit anyway. Even when I was a little boy, I knew you were fucking stupid. Oh, okay. Well, you guys have been the best show of the whole run. Yay. All right. Wow, that's beautiful.
He was gonna fight with the Mickey Mouse here.
That's wonderful. So, sure. I travel a lot as a comedian, and you know what? It really kind of sucks to fly because they don't feed you anymore when you fly domestically. Which would be criminal if they didn't allow you to bring your own food on the plane. That's why whenever I can, I bring Kentucky Fried Chicken. Everyone on the plane is salivating from the smell. You gotta eat it really loud and moan a lot. 11 herbs and spices, baby. That colonel knew what he was doing. 12 spices would have been too many. 10, not enough. Waitress, would you take my vomit bag full of chicken bones, please? I know you don't like to be called waitress, but in my joke, you are called waitress. So last November, I did shows in Switzerland, and Switzerland is a pretty funny country, man. Last year, Muammar Gaddafi petitioned the UN for them to abolish the nation of Switzerland. And you know the guy's not that smart, because he runs his own country and he only made himself a colonel. In my country, colonels make fried chicken. What kind of wife, can do the ironing with her right hand, cook dinner with her left hand, feed her children with her right foot, and please her husband sexually with her left foot? What kind of wife? A Swiss Army wife. It's a sad and disgusting fact, but the country of Belgium within Europe is known for pedophilia. And they've had a real problem with pedophilia in the last 5 or 10 years. And when I was in Switzerland, I did a really stupid joke. I said, you ever think maybe that's the reason why the Belgians make such good chocolate? Because little kids are smart. They won't get into the van for any shitty old chocolate. And I did that joke in Geneva, Switzerland, and after the show, this Swiss woman comes up to me and she goes, your joke about the Belgian child molester, I was wondering why you did not use a Swiss chocolate. I think everyone in the audience was wondering why are they not using the Swiss chocolate. And I just think it's hysterical that the woman was concerned that the child molester in my joke was not using the best chocolate available. I said, lady, let's be honest. If the guy would have had a Toblerone, I would have fucked him, okay? If he would have had a jumbo Toblerone, I'd have put on the Boy Scout suit with the butt cut out, okay, lady? Because that is some good chocolate. Well, everybody, thank you so much for coming out here tonight. God bless you. Everybody, please remember to avoid cops, snakes, and exposed electricity. Never fight anyone uglier than you. They have nothing to lose. Remember that the most beautiful women in the world are Thai men. You guys came out tonight. This is a really special night for me, and I'm actually celebrating, and it's really special for me that you're here. I gave blood a few weeks ago, and it had been a few years since I had a full blood test, so I paid the extra $60 and I got the full blood test. And I do not have AIDS, I do not have hepatitis C, and I do not have syphilis. However, I do have high cholesterol. But that's okay, because people will still fuck you if you have high cholesterol. So get your panties off and bring me some bacon. But it's funny, you have that blood test and you can't help but think about your sexual history. And I was thinking about my sexual history. I've been with some amazing women in my lifetime. It's really made me the man that I am today. But you know, sure, there's been a few trashy hoes. And I was thinking about this trashy hoe with a few years ago. We're having sex and she goes, fuck me with your big dick. I'm like, wait a minute. I have a medium dick. You don't have to boost my confidence. I know what I have. It has served me well. What it lacks in size, it makes up for in cuteness. So please, let's refrain from all this talk of a big dick. However, if you would like to say, do the best you can with your medium dick, that is perfectly acceptable. Do the best you can with your medium dick. I am. I'm doing the best I can with my medium. girl too, man. She was nasty. She was always talk dirty to me, talk dirty to me. And that's not my style. The only way I know to talk dirty to a girl is from the porno movies I've seen. So I'd be like, you love that big black dick, don't you? You love that big black dick, don't you? Love that big black dick, Austin. It's the message of my show. I should have ended. That was gonna end there, and I just. All right. I live in a really old building, and it's haunted with ghosts. And I know that because whenever I jack off, they giggle. It's my impression of the ghost of Red Fox. Oh my God. Boo, dummy. You guys are great. Thank you so much.